It's the captain of the silver screen, Daddy.
I did look pretty good up there, didn't I? What are you up to, Mick?
I'm relating to your journey, man. Dude Love knows a little something about being a star. He's the life of the Pardookie, the center of the universe, the cat's pajamas, just like you.
Lord have mercy.
Yes! Ow! Have mercy! Now that you've had a taste of the good life, you're gonna have to fight to stay at the top of the pack. Everybody wants what you got.
You can say that again.
Everybody wants what you got. So you ready to protect what you have like the international beloved heartthrob I know you are? Even if it means defending against them all at once?
You're damn right, Mick. I'm still the coolest cat and the biggest star, and none of these squares can take that from me.
Then let's get this Pardookie started.
I'm glad to see you decided to stick around WWE. Would have hated to lose you to Hollywood.
There's more I wanted to accomplish here. Probably more for me to learn, too. I mean, you've sure seen a lot in your time here.
I am a 5-time women's champion.
I was actually wondering about some of the stranger things you've encountered. The weird, the otherworldly, the supernatural.
Are you sure you want to be asking me about all that?
Regal said I should explore everything in WWE. Why not?
Of all the ways to become powerful in WWE, the kind of power you're talking about comes with a cost.
Chill. I'm just asking a question. Some of my favorite superstars in WWE have flirted with or embraced the supernatural. The Undertaker, Finn Balor, Bray Wyatt. You?
Even asking is dangerous. You see some of what I'm talking about on TV, sure, but you don't understand how it works. There's a force in WWE, and it's looking all the time for anyone who's open to receiving its gift.
You know what? Maybe I am open to it. Regal told me to let go of all my reservations.
If you're sure, I won't be able to stop you. And it's probably already looking for you. If that's the case, there's something I should give you.
I'm sure.
Okay then. There's a physical manifestation of this power, an artifact. We don't know where it comes from, but it came to me and it's still in my possession. Honestly, I've been trying to get rid of it, but it's too dangerous to simply cast aside.
A physical manifestation?
You've seen the urn. But you haven't seen this. I'll make sure you get it before your next match. Wear it under your gear. This power, it'll open you to possibilities beyond your wildest imagination. Just be careful you don't let it overtake you.
Here she is, the formidable and unflappable Cap.
The following contest is...
Here comes Gigi Dolan, a truly confident and passionate competitor.
And from Atlanta, Georgia, Gigi Dolan!
She came up the hard way and has constantly faced adversity. Worked hard for everything she has, and she's not gonna stop now.
And the thing about Gigi is she is tenacious, sometimes even vicious when she's backed into a corner.
I'm always excited to see the captain in action, but for some reason, I've got chills tonight.
Yeah, there's something in the air. I can't quite put my finger on it.
I think we're gonna see something special tonight, Corey.
Yikes. Rolling elbow. Woo-wee.
Knee to the midsection. Bang to the neck. Turnbuckle's the only thing keeping her upright.
Oh!
Oh, right to the gut.
Gigi catches her by surprise.
These two trading counters, an absolute masterclass.
The vicious streak of Dolan's being put to the test there.
Saw that one coming, took advantage.
Gigi didn't see that coming. Oh, it didn't go as planned there.
Oh, across the top rope.
She's pumping herself up, reaching out for that burst of energy.
She heads out, but this one can be lost by countout. What a forearm. And now she delivers her back into the ring.
If this lands, it might be all over.
Samoan driver. Cinching in a waist lock, but right hands.
Manages to fight out with a series of punches.
Right to the spine. Oh, foot just stomping down.
A bit of provocation from Dolan.
She shoots up the top rope.
Dangerous thinking.
From the top. Nobody home for that one.
Clearly waiting for that. And complete control of their opponent here.
Boom! Into a DDT.
Is it enough? The cover! Two count. An emphatic victory.
Here is your winner, Rachel!
What was that?
What do you mean? I beat you. That was that.
I don't care about losing. No, I mean, I do care about losing, but there was something off with you in that match.
What are you accusing me of?
I don't even know, but whatever it wasn't natural.
Everything's natural if you let it take you, my darling Gigi.
What the heck does that mean?
You'll find out, little girl. Your time will come.
Okay, now you're just being creepy. Are you trying to make me mad?
What's wrong with going mad, Gigi? Madness is intoxicating. Just let go.
Stop trolling me. I'm getting a rematch. No funny business this time.
Commanding the ring and forging her path, the captain!
The following is...
Ladies and gentlemen, get ready for some chaos.
And her partner from Glasgow.
The self-proclaimed Meechan ready to bring a beatdown. Now she's still the head baddie in charge, but now she's also too sweet.
And representing the OC from Fontana, California, Meechan!
knows how to...
As this tag team action gets underway, I actually have chills in anticipation.
Wait a second. Cole, did it just get colder in the arena?
I noticed that too. The moment the captain stepped out, it got different, right? Weird. Rear European uppercut.
This is not going to be good.
Relentless. You could see that each strike drained their opponent's energy.
Wow, what a kick. Bang to the neck.
Just mounted with punches and not... Oh, a nasty stop to finish it off.
Oh, that might have just broken something.
Ooh, vicious kick to the spine. Just a continuous rush on Gigi here.
Gigi has run into a roadblock.
Rolling elbow right on the mark.
Looking wobbly in the corner.
Tag's made.
Whips across the ring. Double shoulder block.
The communication between these two is evident by that move.
And Cross gets stonewalled. Here's a snapmare.
Oh, wait.
Kick right off. Can she do it here? Kick out before the one count.
Still a ways to go in this match based on that.
Oh, Nikki Cross manages the counter.
Big running leg drop.
Here's a tag. Opponent off the ropes.
Double big back body drop.
Tandem offense in effect. A good team. No.
Cat looks like she's trying to end this now, but Gigi's too quick.
Not like Gigi to miss that.
What the heck?
Is Gigi floating?
I don't know what we're looking at. You seen this too, Cole?
Yes, I am. We've only seen forces like this a few times before in WWE, and it's never anything good.
Gigi taps out and Cap for the win.
That's a victory, all right, but I don't think the submission is what people are going to be talking about.
I don't know what to think.
I'm gonna have nightmares about this match.
It's happening, isn't it? I knew it would. How do you feel?
Feelings are irrelevant.
I could tell that's not what you wanted to say. Focus.
I feel incredible. This power, it's intoxicating.
That's better. The amulet is giving you power, but it latches onto the darkness inside of you, whatever kind it finds.
What kind of darkness?
What do you mean?
When it entered me, it found a scared little girl looking for permission to play. Turns out, I was hungry for that release. So that's what I became. What are you hungry for? When you look into your darkness, what do you see? And how do you see yourself?
Mm. Mm. My darkness is older than time itself, from what existed before we had the words to speak of it. What others think is a myth, I know is real.
I see myself in the vestments of our oldest ancestors. Not the gods on high, but those who have fallen. Gold represents the richness of my strength. From the twisted crown of gilded horns upon my head, to the armor that covers my body.
If the darkness of the past is what you see, then that is what will overtake you. Are you sure that's the source of the power?
Yes. That's the darkness I feel coursing through me. And I'm ready to give in to it. What happened in my last match was the darkness and the amulet acting on its own. Now that I understand it, I'll be able to harness it.
If you say so, there's no turning back now.
What in the Lord's name?
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making our way to the ring from Raleigh, North Carolina,
The Undertaker, Kane, Bray Wyatt. I thought I'd seen the spookiest corners of the WWE Universe, but I was wrong.
This is like nothing we've ever seen before. Whatever Cap was before, whoever she was, is gone.
Vitamins, but I am definitely saying my prayers. Meechan ready to bring a beat down. She's still the head baddie in charge, but now she's also too sweet.
And representing the OC from Fontana, California, Meechan!
I've seen it all my time here at WWE, but this is one of the most chilling and shocking competitors to ever step foot in a ring.
These powers aren't of this world, Cole.
I hope Meechan knows what she's getting into, because it's too late to back out now.
Fall by the lariat right to the face. Cinches up the arm in a series of boots.
You can't get caught in a hailstorm like that if you want to win.
Oof. Meechan dodges out in time, and she gets herself out of a precarious position.
Big forearm.
Made her pay for her mistake.
DDT!
Brutal face buster.
Dang!
Measuring.
Oh, face stop.
Meechan is taking a moment to soak it all in.
This one is headed outside, guys.
Lands the knee.
This match is spilled out to the ringside area. And as we can see, tension's really running high now.
Yeah, we should probably clear the way, guys.
In under the ropes. And she delivers a vicious suplex.
That was a gnarly one. Meechin looks dazed.
Guys, what is she doing?
Oh no, it's happening again. She's floating off the mat. And she comes crashing down. What the heck?
Who needs to hook the leg when you can levitate people?
And that'll do it.
Don't blame the official for being apprehensive after that.
I don't think the referee has a choice. I'm getting out of here.
Right behind you.
Really, guys?
I know there was a reason I came here, but for the love of all that's holy, I can't remember what it is. It's like something was pulling me here, you know?
Yes, I called you. I've seen your demon. You recognize my amulet? My power?
Aye, not something I'm anxious to toy with, if I'm being honest.
You fear it?
You should fear it too. I don't think you understand what you're dealing with. The power taps into a darkness inside of us all. You can't ignore it. You can only hope to control it.
So you do understand it. With you as my servant, I will be even more powerful.
No, I...
You don't have a choice.
When do we start?
Now, find me a soul. Together, we destroy her.
Yes.
Thank you.
That was impressive. How did you feel?
Powerful. Ready to take on all of WWE.
In time, controlling the dark side in a match like this is very different than trying to control it in front of a crowd facing another superstar. It feeds off that adrenaline.
Good. I'm getting stronger. It's time.
The fact that you can feel it is exactly why you need to be careful. After a few more matches...
It is only those standing in my way who need to be careful.
Understood. I'll set up a match and pray.
Of Raw can limit Cap's darkness.
That's going to be a tough challenge, especially considering Cap has Finn Balor in her corner.
I'm not sure what this alliance is all about, but considering Finn has some demons of his own, it can't be anything good.
Oh, a nasty stomp to finish it off.
Oh, stomping away.
Setting it up. Boom!
Grabbing a kendo stick. Any connection with flesh will definitely leave a welt.
Ah, blow to the breadbasket. Candace falling victim to a surge of attacks here.
Candace needs to find a way to grab the reins.
He is looking to do some serious harm.
Taking a trip outside, but he's got to be mindful of the count.
And just got caught with that DDT. That's gotta be it. And that's all she wrote.
Here is your winner, Rachel!
A look at the feet on the face of Candice LeRae.
Some could call this a squandered opportunity, but if Candice comes back from this loss even more determined, then it might just be for the best.
That's what I was afraid of.
Me becoming even more powerful.
You going too far? I saw it in your eyes. It took control of you. You need to learn how to harness it, not let it harness you.
I will not deny my power. I will not hold back.
I know what can happen if you stop being able to control it. If you won't slow down and listen, I can't help you anymore. This was a mistake.
Your mistake is saying no. You say I can't harness it. You understand? I can harness you.
What? No. Cap, we can talk.
Punishment has arrived. The priest is more than happy to utilize brute force to get what he wants.
And his opponent, representing the Judgment Day, from New York City, weighing in at 249 pounds.
It's unclear what caused the issue between these two, but looking at Finn Balor's corner, it's easy to guess who.
Finn was in Cap's corner for her last match. Maybe Cap's just returning the favor.
I wouldn't describe his expression as one of gratitude, Saxton. Something nefarious is going on here.
Overhead kick finds the mark.
And Priest looks a little less intimidated after taking some punishment there.
He had to be prepared to take some damage tonight.
DDT!
Wow.
There you have it. Finn Balor locked on his target. Certainly seemed to hit another gear out there tonight.
He looked like a man possessed.
In more ways than one.
Whoa, I'm not sure I like the look of this.
What's happening?
It's the Demon.
Finn Balor's been replaced by his alter ego. We don't need a referee, we need an exorcist.
And unfortunately, he's already taken out the only priest in the building.
I did what you asked, what you compelled. Now please, leave me alone.
Relax. You're free to go. Until I need you again. Then you answer to me. Understand?
I don't.
I do understand. Thank you.
Exactly.
How did you do that?
Because this soul is mine.
With your help, we, the Darkness and I, have taken control.
I have taken control. There is no we.
Fine by me.
You don't understand what you've done. I warned you what would happen. I warned you.
I didn't take it as a warning. I took it as a promise.
The locker room is talking. They're impressed. And they're scared.
As they should be. As you should be.
I've lived in that dark, remember? It burned all my fear away. Has it done the same?
All I feel is hunger.
Then what's happening with your former protege Psycho Sally won't matter to you. Have a good night.
Wait. Tell me of Sally.
She's entered the Queen's Crown Tournament on NXT. And nobody wants her in it. Because of you.
I have nothing to do with the child.
Everybody sees what you've become. They know you were her mentor. They're too afraid of you, but they can touch Sally and want to make an example of her.
If their intention is to hurt me through Sally, they will find themselves on a fool's errand.
Still, I shall watch her from afar, a guardian devil with my fingers on her strings.
Huh. Perhaps the amulet has taken less of you than I imagined.
Get ready for the untamed and unashamed Psycho Sally.
The following contest.
One of the top names in women's independent wrestling, Zoe Stark.
Now looking to prove herself in WWE. The Queen's Crown Tournament always promises a grand showcase for the skill, athleticism, and perseverance of these superstar entries.
Absolutely, Michael. The intensity is palpable. And it's not just standard tournament pressure.
Penny predicament. And there's the kick out.
She still has a lot more in her.
Oh. Oh, man. That kick will stop you in your tracks.
And she dodged that one nicely.
Running Hurricane Run. Fantastic.
Sometimes you just gotta show off and show out.
Able to avoid there.
These two showing how well scouted they each are.
Standing shooting star press. Incredible.
Ooh, stop to the back.
Double stop. And Sally is keeping the match at her pace.
Zoe has to wake herself up and turn her intensity up a notch.
And that can be a first step towards Zoe gaining control.
Stark hoping to start a rush of her own with that.
Off the arm drag, rolled right into a pinning combination.
Great officiating as the rep noticed she was on the ropes.
Zoe moves out of the way.
Reversal! What a counter!
But she still has to do more to get this fully in her favor.
Finds a counter from Stark. She turns it right around with a counter.
Nice cross body.
Oh, now she's looking to apply the pressure with this submission maneuver.
Arm trapped in a submission.
Trouble! Trouble! Great counter, that Fujiwara armbar.
Running Hurricane Rana.
Beautiful. Quick reflex is so important in a match like this.
Ooh, takedown. Skull first.
No, no, no.
Crossbody
to the floor.
Pinpoint precision right on target.
She throws her back in. Into the cover. Gets the shoulder up. Wow. What's it going to take?
She likely knew that wasn't enough. She's just keeping the pressure on.
Ooh. Ooh. She might be in some trouble now.
And hanging tough, but beginning to show some wear and tear. Might want to think about picking up the pace a bit.
She anticipated that one.
Scratching and clawing. This could be it.
The rope stopped the pin.
Psycho
Fighting their way out of this position.
Elbows to the temple.
She's setting something up. Down her DDT.
Starks looking to wrap this one up.
What a response from Sally. Oh, saw it coming.
Digging deep into their well to keep it.
Boom! Devastating clotheslines. And the calf kick.
And this has got to be it. The referee clearly noticed she was on the ropes.
What are we going to see here?
Oh, corkscrew neck breaker.
She's about to rise up to something catastrophic.
Using the ropes as a launching pad.
Oh, no!
That was playing with fire and getting burned.
The decision to take such a risk at this juncture is questionable.
Goes under the ropes to get back inside. Oh, man, watch.
She wants it one more time.
Standing Spanish fly. Are you kidding me?
Incredible.
Two. Psycho Sally gets the win. Stark tastes defeat.
This has to be a difficult loss, but ultimately Zoe Stark was shut down.
It's not something we expected to see, Corey, but Stark will leave here.
Did you see that, Justine? I'm going to the semifinals.
Yes, I did. Really beat the odds on that one, didn't you?
Did I? Gosh, I guess so. That's so cool. Zoe was super tough.
Yeah, Zoe was supposed to knock your freaking block off. I booked you against her for her to win.
Oh? Oh. Oh! That's amazing, Justine! You're right. Always put me in there with people who make me raise my game.
Sally. I don't want you in the tournament because the whole locker room is freaking out. Lights are flickering, there are ghosts in the mirrors, and all the food and catering spoiled.
Okay. What's that have to do with me?
That's all super witchy stuff, Sally. The Cap? You see what she's doing?
I don't know if you noticed when Cap stabbed me in the back and put me out of action for a freaking month, but we aren't always lockstep.
Be that as it may, perception is reality, and everyone thinks there's a hex all over you.
I'm the psycho here, but that sounds pretty cray.
Whatever. Byron Saxton just started calling matches in ancient Sumerian. You need to call off Cap before this gets out of hand.
Justine!
Just do it, Sally!
Psycho Sally, the maven of mayhem and madness.
The following is a Queen's Crown Tournament.
Byron, time to put your hair up and square up. Well, you don't have any hair, but you get the point.
And from Chamonix, New Jersey,
well, if you look up power hungry in the dictionary,
the Queen's Crown Tournament continues, but with a dark cloud hanging over the whole thing.
That's right, Michael. With everything going on these days, it feels like we're holding this tournament inside a haunted house.
These two superstars need to put that out of their minds. They've got a job to do, as do you, Saxton.
I can't help it, Corey. I'm spooked.
Ooh. Oh!
And Sonya avoids that one.
Seeing an answer for every move attempted.
Ooh, four.
Really just laying it in.
No.
A slingshot cross body.
That is tossing your own body around without a care.
Taking no account for their own well-being.
And gets tossed back into the mat. Slingshot. Missed timing with that springboard. And Sally is keeping the match at her pace.
Sonya keeps getting cut down.
Oh my gosh, what impact!
Ooh. Working on the leg.
Oh God. Boom.
I love being on the black and gold brand. Such exciting talent here.
You know it holds a special place in my heart, Cole.
Oh, what a forearm.
Oh, did you hear that? She's showing signs of slowing now.
They've definitely...
Oh, no. What's this?
It's Cap, apparently here to help out her old friend Psycho Sally.
Looking for the suplex.
Elbow! Oh my gosh!
Sonya has to be careful here.
Wow, wiping that smoke.
Will it be?
The referee clearly noticed she was on the ropes.
Oh, wait a second.
Maybe not. Roll up.
Quick count after one.
Still has a great amount of fight in them. Not going to let it end like this. Sonya Deville looking to hype herself up here.
Oof! What a response from Sally.
Boom!
That offense taking a toll on her.
Sonya making that look almost effortless.
Great counter! Oh my God, what a kick! Standing shooting star press, incredible! Cover! There's two! And a victory here tonight!
Here is your winner, Psycho Sally!
They did what it took and got the win. Nicely done.
I'm not sure everyone would agree with you, but that blitz earlier certainly did pay off.
You don't have to like it, but they got the job done.
Only through the use of nasty tactics. That's not a win worth bragging about in my book.
Call thanking you.
Sally, I have gifted you with my power.
which I never asked for, Cap.
After what I did to you before.
After you tried to break my spine with the steel steps to impress your new friend? That? You just like to meddle in my business, even with Alfie.
I got you into the finals against Charlotte. Would you wear a crown? Would you be...
I wanted to win this the right way, Cap. Not with tricks or powers.
I wanted to... help.
Help yourself. Until then, we got nothing to say to each other.
That proved it! That proved Cap has been helping you from afar!
You're right, Justine.
The whole WWE Universe just saw her! Wait, what?
You're right. She's been helping me through the tournament. But that's over now. Cap and I are done.
I didn't expect you to just say it.
Surprise! That's why I want you to set another match. So I can win my way into the finals fairly, on my own. A battle royal against everyone else who entered the tournament.
Damn. I'm impressed.
Tornado of thrills, a whirlwind of wrestling, Psycho Sally.
The following contest is a Queen's Crown Tournament semi-final match.
Here comes the Pride Fighter.
And her opponents, first from Chabon, New Jersey.
One of the hardest working competitors in all of NXT.
Representing the Creed Brothers from Knoxville, Tennessee, Ivy Nile.
You know, Ivy Nile's not the biggest woman around, but Nile has honed her body into a finely tuned weapon.
Here comes an in-your-face superstar, Fallon Henley.
And from Chelsea, Michigan.
A woman who calls herself undeniable.
She's certainly lived up to that moniker thus far.
This is really shaping up to be a tournament. Oh,
she has trouble coming. Not going to be easy to get out of this.
This one,
he's firing off shots to the side and escapes.
Front meet back.
Forearm to the face.
Oh, nothing fancy about that.
Now, that was a very questionable attack. I don't think it goes beyond any gray area.
Flashy, but sometimes you just gotta toss another person to make a statement.
Of that one from all the way over here.
Fucking ladder face first. scouted. Not so fast. Hurricanrana.
Good grief.
Agility like that is what can set you apart from the rest of the locker room.
And make it twice. Ouch.
She's beginning to flag a little.
Yeah, but she clearly has just as much of a chance to come out on top of this battle royal as anyone else here.
Oh, my God.
Every strike more devastating than the last. Side Russian leg sweep. Showing off the quickness. That'll turn things around in a hurry. DDT.
Look at this. Boom. Nice.
Uh-oh. Half and half suplex. Lights out.
Oh, what a clothesline.
Ivy Nile making it clear she has her number.
Oh, strong impact.
Boom. Way to completely disrupt the momentum and buy yourself some time.
Boom, a forearm smash.
It's incredible the inventiveness we are seeing on display here. It takes a certain level of athleticism to pull that off.
Nice takedown. Chop block! Brilliant. Right to the back of the knee.
Just doing anything they can to chip away at the base.
What an elbow drop.
Oh, kick right to the spine.
Drop kick to the back.
Never saw it coming.
And make it twice. Ouch. Battling to stay alive now. Inelegant exit, but if it works, it works.
Has been eliminated.
Just thrown away.
To a surfboard stretch.
Why on earth?
Well, she is desperate to get out of this submission some way, somehow, and she does.
Miraculous. Oh, sit-out slam.
Oh, man.
Bam. Ooh.
Teeth. Oh my goodness, nasty line.
That offense really hitting her hard.
Well, stamina is the name of the game in a battle royal. You gotta be able to endure.
Turns that back on Sonya.
Channeling the energy of this crowd.
I don't really think this is the most opportune time to be looking for the fans' praise. At this point, this is incredibly ill-advised. You're in the middle of a match.
Right in the chest. What a drop kick. Psycho Sally crafting an attack.
Standing Spanish fly. Are you kidding me?
Incredible.
She got launched. Psycho Sally gets the win.
Here is your winner, Psycho Sally.
Big effort tonight.
A well-earned victory here tonight.
She was so committed to walking out the winner. I'm not sure anything could have stopped her.
You did it. Even without your magic buddy pulling strings.
I did, didn't I? If this whole experience has taught me one thing...
Tell me that after you've been in there with Charlotte for 5 minutes. Girl can hit.
Good. She better bring it. Because I'm about ready to go psycho for that crown.
You know what, kid? I think it might look good on you. Good luck out there.
Psycho Sally, the maven of mayhem and madness. The queen has arrived.
And boy, does she know how.
We are down to one final match to crown a true wrestling monarch, with everybody wondering just who will be crowned Queen of the Ring.
And if the last match was any indication, Psycho Sally just might be doing this without Cap's help. I have to say, I'm impressed.
And you're relieved.
Uh-oh, way too close. Oh, diving moonsault! Goes into the pin. Two, sends off the three count.
If she keeps the pressure on, the next one might do it. Big forearm.
Not so fast. Hurricane Rana.
Good grief. And just like that, we've kicked the tempo up a notch.
She did her homework there.
Ah, kick. Nasty kick. And here we go now.
Drops the elbow.
Lock it in, the Dragon Sleeper!
I'm not sure there's anything she can do here. She is showing the world just how much fight she's got left.
It's the mark. The fatigue is setting in for her.
Yeah, Psycho Sally reminding her opponent she's not someone to take lightly.
Looking to do as much damage as possible.
And now thrown back into the ring.
Ooh, stomp to the back and make it twice. Ouch.
Got the underhook. Nice. Can she do it here? Early kick out, referee right on top of the action.
She's still in this one.
And Charlotte displaying this kind of demeanor must be an inherited trait. Boom, what impact! And look at this.
Standing Spanish fly, are you kidding me?
Incredible.
Two! Oh, kick out of two.
I don't know where Charlotte found the strength to kick out of that one.
Was not able to seal the deal with her best move. Way too long. Diving moonsault. Cover. Two. She's done it. In a career-defining victory, Psycho Sally has defeated the queen herself, Charlotte Flair, to win the Queen's Crown Tournament.
Sally overcame so many obstacles to get to this point.
From indie darling to WWE queen, Psycho Sally has made her mark.
Charlotte will be back here, that's for sure. But tonight, she has to hand it to Psycho Sally for this gutsy performance.
God save the Psycho Queen.